How do you reconcile your conduct with the rules under the code of conduct for judges and magistrates?
My Lord, please don't answer yet. I'm refusing to admit this question, one, because he has explained that he was reading a speech of the traditional area. He was nominated to read the speech on behalf of the others. Two, you allowed you all the space to ask your question. Can I be the chairman now?
Yes.
And I'm saying that I'm refusing to admit the question because he has said that he read a speech of the area he represented. And for that reason, it would be difficult to pin that to him as a personal opinion. That's right.
Chairman, can I procedurally we want for the record that we are dissatisfied with your ruling in refusing to admit this particular question of the Honorable Okudjato Abiakwa. Suffice it to add that he's only following up with reference made by the Honorable Titus Glover. And Chairman, this is judicial office, high office of Supreme Court. I think that the nominee is very, very capable, and you should allow him to vindicate himself with an answer to this question. If you disallow it as you've done, we have to come by procedure. It may be difficult, and getting our cooperation going forward will be difficult. Let's do a fair job to him, in all fairness, to him, his person, and the office that he wants to occupy. He said there are audios, the public have access to the audios, but to disallow the question, you'll be making it difficult for us to perform the duty while we are here. We are to assess him, and assess him in respect of his judicial oath, and assess him in respect of his conduct and character as a person to the high office of Supreme Court. So note that we took strong objection to your ruling on this matter.
Objection noted. You may ask another question.
Probably we have to go into a small meeting and come back. We have to. My Lord, the Chief Justice is here, so we should conduct ourselves.
Yes, Honorable Biamwa.
But we have to consult. You have to consult further because this is a fair and legitimate question, which in our view must be answered.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Justice Clemens Jackson Onyemuga, congratulations for your nomination.